Hello friends, welcome to this video. In this video, we will study about the surface area of cuboid. Manas and Thomas have bought a gift for their teacher on the occasion of her birthday.
Thomas, let's cover this gift box with colored paper and decorate it.
Both Manas and Thomas have come to buy colored paper.
Please give us colored paper to decorate this box.
The cost of colored paper is 1 rupee per square centimeter. How much paper do you want?
Manas, how are we going to find out how much paper we will need to decorate this box?
Thomas, we can find the answer to this question through mathematics. It means it's math time! Thomas, can you tell me what is the shape of this box?
This box is a cuboid.
That's right. Suppose the length of this box is L, width B, and height H. If we cut and flatten this cuboid box, its net will be formed and it will look something like this. Let's first find out how much paper we will need to cover surface 1.
The size of paper required to cover any surface will be equal to its area. The surface is rectangular with length L and width H. This means that its area will be length times width or L times H.
And look, Thomas, as you know, the surface 1 and the surface 4 of the cuboid are congruent. This means we will also need L times H of paper to cover the surface 4.
Hey, wow, Manas! We have found the area of paper required to cover the two surfaces. Now, let us also find the paper required to cover surface 3. This surface is also rectangular and has length B and width H. So, to cover it, we need B times H paper. And look, surfaces 3 and 5 are also congruent. This means we will need B times H of paper to cover surface 5 too.
Thomas, now these two remaining surfaces are also congruent. And to cover them, we will need a paper equal to their area, L times B.
Great! So we only have to add the areas of these six surfaces to find the paper needed to cover this cuboid box.
And Thomas, do you know that the sum of the areas of all the faces of any three-dimensional shape is called its total surface area?
Manas, do we have to use such a lengthy process every time to find the total surface area of any cuboid? I am starting to feel dizzy only by the thought of it.
Arey, no, Thomas. Let's write it down in a simple way and make a formula for the total surface area of the cuboid. And Thomas, do you know another interesting thing? If we leave out the bottom and top surfaces of any cuboid, the sum of the area of the remaining surfaces is called the lateral surface area of that cuboid.
This is very interesting. This means that the lateral surface area of the cuboid of length L, width B, and height H will be equal to the sum of the area of these four rectangular surfaces. But there are also two pairs of congruent surfaces here. So we can write it in this way as well. Manas, we also got the formula for the lateral surface area of a cuboid.
Let me write the length, width and height of my box. 6, 3, and 12 centimeter respectively in this formula. Look, Thomas, the total surface area of our cuboid box is 252 square centimeters, and the lateral surface area of the cuboid box is 216 square centimeters. We will need 252 square centimeters of paper to completely cover our cuboid box.
Manas, today we learned two new formulas. Let me quickly write them in our math formula book.
Let us now go back and decorate this box with beautiful colored paper and give it to our teacher.
The two friends together decorated the gift with beautiful colored paper and gave it to their teacher. Friends, if the length, width and height of a cuboid box are 15 centimeters, 5 centimeters and 2 centimeters respectively, then can you find the total surface area and lateral surface area of this box? We will see the solution to this question in the next video. Till then, try to find a solution to this question with your friends. In this video today, we learned about the surface area of cuboid. In the next video, we will see some interesting examples based on this. Hello friends, welcome to this video. In the previous video, we learned about the surface area of cuboid. Friends, did you find a solution to this question asked in the previous video? This is the formula for the total surface area of a cuboid, where L, B and H are the length, width and height of the cuboid. Here, we will write the length of the box 15 centimeters, the width 5 centimeters and the height 2 centimeters respectively in place of L, B and H. In this way, we get the total surface area of the cuboid as 230 square centimeters. Now, in the same way, we will also write the length of the cuboid 15 centimeters, width 5 centimeters and height 2 centimeters respectively in place of L, B and H in the formula of lateral surface area of the cuboid. The lateral surface area of the cuboid is 80 square centimeters. Well done, friends! Your answer is absolutely correct. Now, in this video today, let us look at interesting examples based on the surface area of cuboid.
Manas, what are you doing with this suitcase? Are you going on a holiday?
No, Thomas. I want to sew the cover for this suitcase. But I'm not able to understand how much fabric I will need to cover these four surfaces of the suitcase.
Manas, we can find the solution to your question through mathematics. Do you know what it means?
Absolutely! That means it's math time!
Manas, the suitcase is a cuboid and all you have to do is cover its vertical surfaces. Look closely. Tell me, what part of the suitcase do these vertical surfaces form?
Oh yes! This is the lateral surface of this cuboid shaped suitcase.
Perfect! This means that the amount of fabric we need to cover these surfaces will be equal to the lateral surface area of this cuboid suitcase. So now can you find the answer to how much cloth will be required to cover the suitcase?
Friends, If the length, width and height of the suitcase are 1.5 feet, 0.5 feet and 1 feet respectively, then can you find the lateral surface area of this cuboid shaped suitcase? If you want, you can find the solution by stopping the video.
According to the formula written in the formula book, this is the formula for the lateral surface area of the cuboid, where L, B and H are the length, width and height of the cuboid respectively. The length, width and height of the suitcase are 1.5 feet, 0.5 feet and 1 foot respectively. Let me write these measurements here instead of L, B and H. Look, Thomas, I need 4 square feet of fabric to cover these surfaces of the suitcase.
Well done, but it will cost you a lot of money to buy the cloth. Do you know that the tailor sells 1 square feet cloth for 40 rupees?
40 rupees for a square feet of cloth, and I need 4 square feet of cloth for the cover of the suitcase. That means I would need a total of 40 times 4, 160 rupees. Mother has given me 200 rupees, so I will be able to buy this cloth.
Let's now quickly return to our world and buy the cloth to cover your suitcase.
The two friends bought 4 square feet of cloth from the tailor and got a beautiful cover stitched for Manas's suitcase. With this example, we have seen how our daily life problems can be solved using the concept of surface area of the cuboid. In the next video, we will see some more fun examples related to this. Welcome to this video. In the previous video, we saw some interesting examples based on the surface area of cuboid. In this video, we will see some more fun examples related to this.
Thomas, why are all your shoes scattered like this?
Yes, I have also been thinking since a long time that I should make cardboard boxes to keep them.
Let me help you.
Manas, we will both make boxes of exactly the same dimensions. The length, width and height of the box should be 35 centimeters, 25 centimeters and 12 centimeters respectively.
The two friends made similar cuboid boxes.
Manas, we both made similar boxes. But my box opens like this from the top and your box opens from the right side. So, have we both used the same amount of cardboard?
We can find the answer to this only through mathematics. That means it's math time! My box opens from the right side like this. So, this right surface is not present in my cuboid box. This means that to estimate the cardboard used to make the box, I need to find the sum of the areas of these surfaces. But the sum of the areas of these surfaces can be found by subtracting the area of this right surface from the total surface area of this cuboid box. Let me write the formula for the total surface area of the cuboid written in the formula book. And the area of the right surface is equal to the height multiplied by the width of the box. Let me show this here by writing B times H. Now, I just have to solve this by writing the length of my box 35 centimeters, width 25 centimeters and height 12 centimeters respectively in place of L, B and H. Let me solve it quickly. Oh, 2890 square centimeters of cardboard has been used in my box.
Let us see how Captain Thomas found the amount of cardboard used in his cuboid box.
My box opens like this from the top. So this top surface is not present in my box. To estimate the cardboard used in the box, I need to add the areas of these remaining surfaces. These vertical surfaces then provide the lateral surface area of this cuboid box. This means that I can find this sum by adding the area of its base to the lateral surface area of the cuboid box in this way. This formula is written for the lateral surface area of a cuboid in the formula book. Let me write it here. And I know that the area of the bottom surface of the box is equal to its length times the width. So, I will write L times B here in the place of the area of the bottom surface.
Friends, if the length, width and height of Thomas's box are 35 centimeters, 25 centimeters and 12 centimeters respectively, can you find the cardboard used in Thomas's box? Pause the video to try on your own and then match your answer.
I can find the cardboard used in my box in this way. 1740 square centimeters of cardboard has been used in my box. Manas, 2890 square centimeters of cardboard has been used to make your box, and 1740 square centimeters of cardboard has been used for my box. Look, we both have exactly the same dimensions, but because of the different way our boxes are opened, the measurements of the cardboard used to make our boxes are different.
You understood it right, Thomas. Now let us quickly return to our world and make our boxes and put your shoes in them before your mother returns.
The two children made more boxes together and packed Thomas's scattered shoes in them. Friends, in this video, we saw another interesting example based on surface area of cuboid. So hopefully, you now have a good understanding of the surface area of cuboid.